Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Today is Monday, April 20th. That's when this podcast is going out. I have an unusual request for the right person. This Thursday, April 23rd, 2009, I'm going to be driving from, I'll probably start out around Kansas City, Missouri, up to Rapid City, South Dakota. And I am looking to do a podcast live with someone who works somewhere here along I-29. So if you're in Omaha or within 5 or 10 minutes of I-29, you'd like me to stop by the office, you'd like to ask your Excel question live on the podcast, shoot me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. Probably going to be sometime during the morning of April 23rd, heading from that seminar the day before in Springfield, Missouri, going up to the Friday seminar in Rapid City. Looks like a nice drive, great place to do a little Excel podcasting along the road. Now, today I have a problem, and I'm not sure that I have a good solution. At least neither solution I'm very happy with, and I'm putting this out there to see if you have a better solution. Rich sent in this question. He says, there's a great setting here called center across selection. So if I type something in cell E3 and then I go into the alignment tab of format cells under horizontal, we have center across selection. And it doesn't merge the cell or anything like that. It just centers across the selection. It's a great feature. And Rich says, why don't they have that for vertical cells? So for example, if I put store ID here, why can't I get it to center across selection vertically? And sure enough, if we go in there to the alignment tab under vertical, there is no option for center across selection. And what Rich has to do, he has two options. One of them is merge cells. And I hate merging cells. Where we actually turn on merge cells and then say vertical center, click OK, and you see that now creates one big cell. The problem with merge cells is, let's say that we're over here and we try and select the whole row. That's Shift Spacebar to select the whole row. Well, because it hits that merge cell, it selects 5 rows. Very, very frustrating. The other solution is to use a text box or some sort of a shape over here. So if we come to Insert, and then Shapes, and then Text Box. I'm going to hold down the Alt key to make sure that it stays perfectly in this range. And then in that text box, I can type Store ID. And we will select the text box. And now Format Cells, Control 1, or Format the object. And let's see, Text Box, Vertical Alignment Center, Middle Center, there we go. Text direction horizontal. Also, we can change the font to something smaller. There we go. And we get something that is similar to center across selection, but certainly a lot harder to set up. So, wonder if you have ever run into this, if you've ever tried to center across selection vertically, and what your solution is. Again, drop me a note, bill@MrExcel.com, and we might get you on a future podcast. And then this Thursday, April 23rd, if you happen to be along that I-29 corridor there, going from Kansas City on up to Rapid City, South Dakota, I'd love to stop by your office and do a podcast live. Shoot me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. Well, there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.